country pub that thinks it's Claridge's.
Is this pub food? Because I can't quite believe I'm fucking standing in a traditional English pub.
This week, I'm trying to help the most stubborn fruitcake I've ever met.
I love Bates.
Now, where did that one come from?
7 days to teach this old dog some new tricks.
Just remember, we are the bosses.
It will take a miracle.
Fucking come and tell me. Yeah? Because I'll smash them over your fucking head.
The Lune Valley, a wealthy farming area in the heart of the Lancashire countryside. Home of the hot pot and the custard tart, and a great location for a roadside pub.
I'm looking for the Fenwick Arms, a good old traditional English pub.
Every day, thousands of punters speed past the pub. It's slap bang on the busy A683 between Lancaster and Kirby Lonsdale. Pubs are now the nation's favourite place to eat out, and Brian Ray has spent the last 30 years cooking pub food.
I don't claim to be God, I don't claim to be Jesus, but in my business and in my kitchen, my word is law.
There's a mint to be made if you get pub food right. But since Brian and his partner Elaine Howden took over the Fenwick Arms 3 years ago, they've been hemorrhaging money at a rate of 1,500 quid a week.
What's going on up there? One big overgrown bush. Fuck me. And here is the menu. Okay. Oh, shit.
This is...
Elaine.
Elaine, nice to see you. And...
Hello, I'm Brian.
Brian, how are you?
Oh, I'm fine.
Good.
Delighted to meet you.
Likewise, good to see you.
Very delighted.
God, it's tight in here, isn't it?
Yep.
So where's the restaurant?
Dining area is this way.
Follow us down then.
This is supposed to be a traditional English pub, but it's full of tacky clutter, and when it comes to table settings, Brian's got serious delusions of grandeur.
God, extraordinary. Not what I imagined as a pub.
We used to have this just as a small dining room with four tables in it.
God, looks like you've got the Queen coming for fucking dinner, no?
Unfortunately, no one's coming for dinner. But it's not for want of trying. Brian and Elaine are throwing everything at this failing business.
We spend most of our life down here. Anything between 100 and 120 hours a week down here.
120 hours a week? 60 hours each?
Yeah.
No. 120 each.
So what days off do you take?
We don't.
So you don't take days off?
We had Christmas Day off this year.
That was your last day off?
Yep, and the day before that was the previous Christmas, and the day before that would have been about 18 years ago.
Jesus.
I had 6 days off for a quadruple heart bypass. But I was back at work on the seventh day.
Fucking hell. You're back at work 7 days later?
Yep,
7 days after the op, I was back working in the kitchen cooking.
Are you mad?
Probably.
How old are you?
62.
62. Christ.
Brian is killing himself over an empty pub. This place should feel laid back and lively, but it's got all the formality and awkwardness of a wake.
It stays. You know, the atmosphere is static and very dreary.
So our menu for this evening.
Thank you.
Plus the additions of the day. Care for a wine list? Brian calls them additions rather than specials. Doesn't like to call them specials.
I see. But it's far from being a pub menu, is it? God. Red Johnson's corn-fed goosenard duck breasts, Ribble Farmhouse Savoy cabbage, rosti potato, Willington crispy apple chutney and Calvados jus. Fuck me.
Brian's trying way too hard. And his list of pompous sauces is ridiculous.
I mean, there's pure Merlot, red wine sauce, jus, Calvados jus, Lancashire jus, caramelised onions, tartar. Extraordinary. You walk into a pub and you expect a steak kidney pudding, a shepherd's pie.
I've ordered the simplest thing on the menu, a prawn salad. But Brian doesn't do simple.
We'd like to point out
first and foremost, we're a traditional old English pub. Bloody hell.
What happened?
That's steeped in tradition there, isn't it?
Let's see if Brian can get traditional with my main course. But I'm doubtful. It's Cockerham rack of lamb, balsamic cherry tomatoes, and one of those pretentious sauces.
How the fuck do you get in? How do you get the lamb out?
Not only is this not pub food, but it's plain awful.
Mm. Honestly, it's like chewing a fucking golf ball.
Brian's got a lot to answer for.
This is a pub, isn't it?
Yes.
And that's what I had to keep on telling myself. A traditional old English pub.
So how many pubs have you been in that have served a over-reduced, syrupy, sickly balsam with vinegar in a Z shape over a square plate?
Probably none.
A pub or pub grub is the next step up from home. No, it's that basic. Rustic, honest, good, British, solid food. There's nothing traditional about what you're doing here. This is currently running as a restaurant that is confused, over the top, I mean, absurd beyond belief. You're not running a pub. It feels like you're running a restaurant badly.
Modern pub food is all about simple home cooking done well. But I don't think it's going to be easy persuading Brian and Elaine that they need to get back to basics.
How you feeling?
Totally crap. It was pretty devastating last night. Some of the things, yes, we could fully accept and take.
Uh-huh.
But to be quite honest, the way we felt, if you have to be like that to get to the top, I'm glad I'm at the bottom.
I've got to be brutally honest. Clearly, you don't like that level of honesty. I'm not here for a confrontation. And, you know, if you're that devastated on the back of what you've been through in this industry for 30 years, I'm surprised you're so weak.
After 30 years hard graft, Brian and Elaine should be reaping the benefits. But in fact, they're facing bankruptcy and could be homeless in 3 months. They've got to face facts.
How much are you in debt?
When we actually sat down and wrote it down, tossed it all up, put everything into it, well, you sort of leave things out so that you don't see it. We're about $250,000.
In debt? If we had to close tonight.
Uh-huh.
The situation at the Fenwick Arms is desperate. I need to find out how Brian runs his kitchen. Since his heart op, his memory lets him down, so he sets a timer for every dish he's cooking.
And that helps you not to forget when it's ready.
Well, it's not just that, it's giving you an awareness all the time that time's passed.
So how many timers you got going on?
Just one at the moment.
Three times.
Brian's short-term memory is as awful as the rich, sticky sauce he's coating every dish.
This one?
And that, I believe, is a previous scrumpy reduction. We actually didn't have a lot of cider.
So it's a scrumpy reduction without the scrumpy?
Appletize reduction.
With appletize in there? Appletize. Fuck me, I feel sick.
I'm starting to realise nothing about this kitchen makes sense.
Have you got any mash ready for us, Nate? Have we got a bowl for that?
While Brian runs round the tiny cramped space, he's paying top whack to his most experienced chef, Nathan, who seems to just put pass in everything.
This is normal, or someone taking the piss at me? This is normal?
It's normal.
I've never seen such a chaotic and inefficient kitchen. And on top of that, there's Brian's overcomplicated and, frankly, ridiculous food.
Stone-cold pâté, stone-cold lettuce, piping hot pigeon, red wine sauce, parsley. Hey, you've got a fucking brain, haven't you?
I hope so. Yeah. I like to think so.
Is this pub food?
No.
Because I can't quite believe I'm fucking standing in a traditional English pub.
Brian's already had 5 heart attacks and he's running himself into the ground, cooking the wrong food in the wrong way.
Your kitchen is a disaster zone. It is fucking impossible to get food out of there.
Well, I tell you what, big boy, you may be 62, but fuck me, you don't have to work that hard, you know that?
That'd be nice if it isn't.
I swear to God. Because that must be a fucking nightmare in there.
The Fenwick Arms in Lancashire has ideas above its station. It's a country pub with aspirations to be a fancy restaurant. The dining room is set for the Queen and the food is pretentious. Brian Ray and Elaine Howden are over £250,000 in debt, but they're still spending.
You've got a setup of a restaurant, big coffee machine, espresso. Expensive bit of quit, this, no?
I picked it up for £400.
400 quid?
Yeah.
You bought it?
Yeah.
From where?
eBay.
eBay?
Yeah.
Brian stuffed his kitchen with so much second-hand equipment, you can't swing a cat.
Let me just squeeze past here. Thank fuck you're small, you know that?
Huh? It's an asset at times.
I know, that's what you do. You look for chefs on eBay, look at their size, their measurements, their weight, then employ them, yes?
Brian's DIY kitchen is a cramped, botched-together disaster zone, held together with bits of string. And his hoarding problem goes much deeper than I first thought.
I love plates. Whereas other people go and have a holiday or go out for a meal, I'll save my pennies and buy a plate.
Jesus, fuck me. Look, all those plates there, wrapped in clinfilm. Why are they wrapped in clinfilm?
Stay clean.
To stay clean?
Yeah.
Right. What are these plates used for?
Just some I bought to play with.
Some you bought to play with?
Yeah, and we haven't played with them yet. Just got the chance of getting them, so I got them.
What do you think of putting there? Salad, soup?
I don't
soup?
Know. We'll come up with some dish and use them for that.
No. Come on. You don't serve food in them, do you?
Yes, we did.
Oh, no, come on. I wouldn't even put a fucking dog's dinner in there. You don't serve food in them.
We have done in the past.
No. Look at the size of it!
They're big.
I mean, you can go tiling with that thing. You know that? We can retile this whole establishment with these plates. Just look what we can start doing in terms of... Look. Already it's starting to look unique, isn't it?
Yep.
And so you said, what Chinese dish on this one?
It wasn't. It was a Japanese dish.
Christ almighty.
The tile glue didn't stick.
Shit.
It's all right, don't worry. Shit. It was chips anyway.
Sorry. Damn.
Every corner I turn, I discover another of Brian's stashes squirreled away.
Now, where did that one come from?
I bought that from Villeroy Bock.
Fucking hell. And what's that? You don't serve food on that, come on.
Yes, we do.
It's like a fucking swimming pool for Barbie. Now we've got one with three compartments down the side.
We served the steak on that.
You served the steak on that?
Yep.
A lifetime of hoarding calls for shock treatment.
For the first time ever, we're going to get rid of that fucking junk.
Before I can even think about changing the food, I've got to make some space.
Condemned, broken, chipped, skipped. Yeah?
Yep.
This. Where did you get this thing from?
eBay.
Tucked away in the corner, Brian's got a huge, disgusting stock pot. It's the base for all his revolting sauces.
That's going to go in the skip. We don't need to fucking have the Shiraz, the Merlot. We don't need it. That, for me, is a hazard. Do we need that hot plate?
Well, it's usually a way of keeping the food hot.
Brian's been collecting kitchen equipment for 30 years. He's never thrown anything away. And even with me here to help, he's finding it difficult.
Bit of a shock to the system. It's a hell of a shock to the system.
Some of these items here you're going to keep. Some of them here you're going to sell. And some of them you're going to chuck. Pin it, tag on there.
Left to his own devices, I know Brian would put all this junk back. So I'm forcing him to decide how much of it is actually essential to running the kitchen.
I don't want to get rid of that yet. There. I just want to keep that top. It's a tabletop. I don't want to get rid of that.
Oh dear, he's hopeless.
I'm going to keep them, because I'll have to find somewhere for them.
How many microwaves do we need?
Keep one or two.
One. Three? What are you doing with three microwaves?
One.
One. And one spare.
I
I've been trying to get rid of some of this rubbish for 2 or 3 years, but Brian will not part with anything.
I'm leaving Elaine in charge of rebuilding the kitchen while I make sure that Brian's junk has gone for good.
OK, why do you think I brought you here?
I have no idea.
You got no idea? Well, see that skip behind there? That's full of your junk. And I'm really worried the fact that you're going to put half that junk back in your kitchen. So I've got to get rid of it once and for all. Go on, get that stockpot away. We're getting rid of the shit. Look at it. Stop hoarding crap.
I think you've well and truly made the point.
The harsh truth is that 20 rural pubs close every month, and if Brian and Elaine don't want to add to that number, they need to start making some drastic changes.
Got a huge amount of respect for fucking Brian. The guy's 62 years of age. He's been cooking for 30 years. He hasn't got a fucking pot to piss in. He's working in excess of 120 hours a fucking week in a kitchen. I'm sorry, but for any man at 62, that can kill you.
Clearing out the junk was just the beginning. Before I can start changing that god-awful food, I need to get this kitchen working properly.
Look at the space you've got here like that. Hey, we're going to throw a fucking dance in here in a minute.
I've got to do something drastic. I need to clear out one final thing from the kitchen. Brian.
Brian, big night for you tonight. Don't be scared of a change. You're not cooking in the kitchen tonight. You are out of the kitchen for good. And you are more capable of running your pub, but not from the kitchen. As a proper publican, as a proper host.
I will do my best.
Please go and get changed.
I will.
I think this kitchen's got a better chance without Brian. He's got a young but enthusiastic team of three chefs, Nathan, Karen and Chris.
I know how difficult Brian is to work with. That is so fucking obvious. Yeah? He's gone now. Yeah? He's not running the kitchen, he's running his business. Show him that you can do it.
It's essential that the Fenwick Arms has a friendly couple out front. But I'm not convinced Brian will be up to the job after 30 years behind the stove.
Good evening. Did anybody tell you we've run out of sea bass and we've only got one tian left? Right. Anybody any ideas on what you're looking for? Before we run out of what's left?
Oh dear. Not exactly a polished performance.
Went that way.
Talk to them, Brian. They won't bite. But it's looking much more professional in the kitchen, where Karen has taken charge.
Don't worry about drizzling the plate, just sauce the fucking thing, please. There you go. Good.
Even with Brian's complicated menu, the food is flying out of the kitchen, just like it should do in a pub.
They're doing a great job in there. Now the problem's in the dining room. And there's no vibrancy.
The atmosphere is stuffy and formal. Why on earth is Elaine pouring the wine? This is supposed to be a pub. While Brian and Elaine fuss over their customers, there are empty tables in the dining room, and the bar is filling up with people waiting to eat. They're never going to make a profit running it like this. They need to fill the tables twice a night.
What's happening in the bar? Everyone's sitting in there taking orders. Get them straight to the fucking table. Get them in the restaurant. Clear the bar.
Can I pass you some menus? Are these ladies part of your party?
Ryan has got to loosen up, or they'll never speed up the service.
First of all, you guys, yeah, fucking well done. I mean, really well done. My problem was in the dining room.
Your service doesn't need to be that formal. If you relax, the service will relax. And that's not nitpicking. We're a pub.
Yeah.
What's wrong with them carrying their own drinks through to the table?
Nothing you know whatsoever. Yourself why the atmosphere is not right. You know it's not running smoothly.
Of course you do. We need to work on that level of just a pub.
I've only got 3 days to go, and I've still got to solve the biggest problem at the Fenwick Arms, Brian's food.
What is traditionally English pub food? What is it?
Well, I suppose English pub food is basically scampi, gammon, sausage, that. But that isn't what I want to be.
Nothing of the sort. Fuck me, what pubs have you been in?
Not quite so many since I ended up in one myself.
It's rustic, simple English cooking. Whether it's a bowl of split pea soup, whether it's a Lancashire hot pot, whether it's steak and chips, it is simple food.
And that's where I've lost my way, then.
It's time I pushed Brian in the right direction.
See this on here? Twaddle, yeah? Absolute horrendous waffle. I don't want to see the Madeira sauce, the citrus mayonnaise. I don't want to see a Calvados jus. No more sauces. The pub will be serving great British pub food.
I've got to start replacing some of Brian's dishes with good home cooking.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's wrong with having Lancashire hot pot on the menu?
Nothing, no.
Nothing at all. Where are we?
Lancashire.
Yeah. And so why is that not on the menu?
I've asked Brian and Elaine to rewrite the menu minus the waffle.
Pan-fried duck livers. Just fried duck livers.
Fish cake.
Just put down. Fish cake.
Potatoes on top? Lots of potatoes, yeah? Spread nice. Good. Give it a little twist at the bottom like that. That mixes the onions and the potatoes. Yeah, up, on top, and in. What have you done for the fish cake?
Salmon and haddock fish cake.
Salmon and haddock fish cake.
Yeah. And that's it?
Yep.
Wow. Finally, we're getting somewhere. I feel that we're really starting to fucking understand what a pub means.
Progress at last. But I don't think they really understand what a pub is until they've been to one. So I'm giving them the night off. Their first Saturday night out in 18 years.
Good. Right, Elaine. Brian, take the dog for a walk. Don't worry about the service.
Right.
When you come back, okay, get changed, yeah, and come and have dinner. When was the last time you sat in here on a Saturday night and watched your staff at work and enjoyed your dinner?
Never.
Never.
Right. Okay. Off you go.
Thank you, guys.
See you later.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
See you later. Right. Now, one last thing. You're the only pub in Britain that's got a fucking uniform. Get changed into your civvies, see you in 5 minutes, ready to run the place, yeah?
There's a good boy. There's a good boy. Come on, mate.
I'm hoping that if Brian and Elaine experience a real pub atmosphere, they'll realise relaxed is best. So tonight, there'll be no fussy service at the Fenwick Arms.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
And welcome to the Fenwick Arms. How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Good, good, good. You can't come in.
You too busy?
No, we're not too busy. You're not here to receive an OBE. You're here to have dinner. You're dressed too formal.
We'll go back again.
As quick as you can.
Right, come on.
Lovely.
We've never been out ever not dressed like this.
Right, come back with something casual. Welcome to the Fenwick Arms. Come through, please.
Tonight, they'll be sampling the first of my new real pub grub. Not a sticky jus in sight.
It's a rather nice colour, isn't it?
You want to taste this, Patty?
It's good.
With that. That is to die for.
The food has been a hit. I hope they've finally got the message that they've got nothing to fear from going back to basics.
You've got to show flexibility, and you can do it.
Yeah.
And getting you out of this place today was a breath of fresh air, just to relax the place. And the more you can relax, I swear to God, you're going to see your business grow.
Last night was a success. I thought the Fenwick Arms was back on track. But this morning, I've discovered Brian had gone behind my back and jeopardised everything we've been trying to achieve.
We had a really good night last night and the staff worked fucking exceptionally well. Straight after I left, Brian came downstairs and started being a cantankerous old bat.
Right, I'm just going to have a word with him. Yeah. In fact, both of them, because I'm getting a little bit fucking pissed off. The minute my back's turned, then...
What was his complaint to you this morning?
It was generally that he doesn't want to see any of his plates being binned, he doesn't want anything being different. He came around, took all his knives out. It was just generally, this is our business, this is our home, things aren't going to be changing as much as anybody thinks, we're still going to be doing it our way and nobody's going to say any different.
He's stuck in his ways.
And his dog, really.
Yeah, but how pissed off are you?
On a scale of 1 to 10?
Yeah.
I'd give it a good 7.
Unbelievable. 2 days to go and he decides to screw it all up.
At 62 years of age, it's becoming really fucking clear that you can't teach an old dog new fucking tricks.
I'm nearing the end of my week at the Fenwick Arms, where I'm trying to save Brian and Elaine from the jaws of bankruptcy. But just when I thought we'd turned the corner, Brian's gone behind my back and told his staff he won't accept my changes.
I want to get it out with you now, because I don't mind going. I'd rather go and see my wife today than sit here and fucking bang my head against the wall. If you're not prepared to accept the changes, you've got to tell me. And the nitpicking, do you know what? You've got to balance it out with some confidence and a little bit of encouragement.
I said to them this morning, right? Just remember, we are the bosses.
It's not a power struggle. You are definitely the owners. Just cut them a little slack. You'll be surprised.
You know what we're acting like? Small children, aren't we?
Thank you. They're busting their nuts off for you right now.
They're busting their nuts off for you right now.
That's not for me. That's for you, because you pay their fucking salaries, not me. And when you're worried about your Villeroy and rock fucking plates that no one's changing, fucking come and tell me. Yeah? Because I'll smash them over your fucking head.
He better have listened this time. I'm only here for 2 more days, and a bigger concern is that it's Sunday on a bank holiday weekend and the pub is virtually empty.
Sunday lunch normally this quiet, or?
Sunday lunch is a bit hit and miss. Some weeks you can have quite a few in, other weeks you can have maybe 6 or 10 in.
Here we are sat at 1:45, 25 covers done. I mean, we should be having a second seating coming in now for Sunday lunch.
But thank God only 25 people are going to eat the miserable looking roast they're serving today. It's coated in yet another disgusting brown sauce.
Is that Brian's recipe?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a revolting concoction of gravy granules and reduced red wine. I may have kicked Brian out of the kitchen, but unfortunately, his influence still lingers on.
I suppose we could always fucking retile the roof on that fucker, can't we? Look at that. Fuck me. Why is it so dark?
But the Yorkshire puddings are actually pretty impressive. What a shame they're going to be ruined by Brian's disgusting gravy.
Why isn't this place packed out for a Sunday lunch?
We don't know. We just don't know. We have no idea. It's... we've tried different menus.
Yep.
We've had bigger, we've had shorter. We've tried all sorts.
Yeah.
But...
look how busy the fucking road is.
Yeah.
You should be fucking ramming them in Sunday lunch.
Yep.
Turnover needs to increase by at least £2,000 a week. I think Sunday lunch holds the key to solving the problem. But there's only one thing Brian's gravy is good for.
Yeah, we're saying goodbye to the gloop and hello to gravy. Hey! Fucking hell! We got some tarmac!
Okay.
One thing we're going to do now is make a proper gravy, yes? When was the last time we made a proper gravy?
Years ago.
Years ago?
Yeah.
Fresh oil in there, yeah? And carrots, leeks, celery, yeah?
Yeah.
And it's really important to make the gravy in the tray the meat was roasted in. And now, stock. Beef stock, yeah? Bring that up to the boil.
Yeah.
Right, and when I pass this through a sieve, I want to see the bottom of the tray.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice and clean, yeah?
What happens? All the vegetables start to go through the sieve.
so it naturally thickens the gravy. Out, and look, gravy.
This has given me a great PR idea that's going to appeal to Brian's eccentric personality and give the Fenwick Arms the boost it so desperately needs.
That was an ovi-busy lunch, was it?
No.
And we took how much?
I didn't do a reading.
60-something.
400 quid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eight of us on there. Barely enough to pay the wages. Barely enough. Yeah? The penny dropped for me today. You know that. Why can't this place become famous for gravy?
Brilliant idea.
Look at these things. They're amazing. You've got the amazing potential to have a fantastic Sunday lunch. Bring back real gravy. This place will be fucking heaving.
How?
Yes.
How? You get on the streets and you just announce, okay, that you've got a campaign to launch real gravy at the fucking Fenwick Arms. Yes? A campaign to launch real gravy. Hey, it sounds a little bit fucking doolally, but why can't you just turn it around and get out on the street with the team, yeah?
Yes.
Give us a word.
Yes, we will launch the campaign.
As I hoped, Brian is well and truly sold on the campaign.
Join the campaign for real gravy! Join the Fenwick Arms for real gravy!
His troops are armed with Yorkshire puddings and jugs of gravy, and we're ready to hit the streets of Kirby Longsdale.
Yorkshire pudding and just a little bit
join
of gravy
the
there.
Campaign
Thank
for
you.
Real gravy!
Sir? Real gravy, there we are.
No more jus, no more sauces, real gravy! No more seps, no more vinegars, just real traditional British gravy!
Oh yeah!
Bollocks to Fisto! Bollocks to Maggie! The campaign for real gravy starts at the Fenwick Arms, Clapton! The centre of the universe for real gravy!
Nice. Happy, good man.
Gravy! We want gravy! We want gravy!
Great word of mouth publicity is unbeatable, and Brian and the team have done a brilliant job making damn sure the Fenwick Arms is the talk of the town.
We want gravy! Not just any gravy, but the real gravy!
We relaunch tomorrow, and when word spreads about the real gravy, the pub should be packed out.
There you are. Join our campaign. Real gravy.
It's my last day, and there's still a lot to do before tonight's relaunch. First impressions count, so there's no point launching a big PR campaign if the place looks a dump when the punters get here.
Have a look at that sign. It cheapens the place, and it just sends the wrong messages. You know that? Huh? And I want to see the Fenwick Arms, so that banner, you know, that's got to go. And the whole place just needs sprucing up a little bit. Jet hose the front and just get it nice and vibrant.
While the front of house teams spruce up the exterior, I've suggested to Brian that he gets back on eBay and starts selling off his huge crockery collection.
I've got 10 of those and they're starting off at 46 quid each.
I may have done the impossible and got Brian selling his plates, but I've got a feeling he won't find staying out of the kitchen so easy. I need Elaine to keep an eye on him when I'm gone.
There's one person that can make sure that he doesn't go back to his old ways, is you.
Yeah, yeah. I shall remind him. I think he'll listen.
You've got to keep him out of that kitchen. You cannot let him back in there.
I just think he was frightened of being...
jobless.
Just put on the shelf and forgotten about.
Yeah.
And he didn't want to feel as though they could manage without him, even though he knew that.
No.
It's the same with me.
But he's got that competition streak in him. He's 62, though. He doesn't need to be that competitive with his staff.
No, he doesn't. But you could see the passion he's had.
Oh, God, 30 years?
Yeah.
Yeah, easily. Like I said, there's not many that have lasted that long. But it's about time he started to enjoy it a little bit, no?
tonight we're relaunching the Fenwick Arms as a great British pub. The Real Gravy campaign has done the trick. Bookings have been pouring in all day.
Good afternoon, Fenwick Arms.
On a normal Tuesday night, Brian and Elaine would be lucky to get 20 customers, but there's already 88 booked in for tonight's relaunch.
8 o'clock. Yeah, we could maybe do it going on towards 8:30.
In the kitchen, I've put together a new menu of no-nonsense, tasty British pub favourites. There's hearty pea and ham soup, and the all-time classic, yeah. A simple prawn cocktail.
A few prawns in the middle. Yeah, what's the secret behind a prawn cocktail?
Good prawns.
Good prawns. Lovely Mary Rose sauce. And
a little bit of apple.
The apple and the lettuce, yeah? Just really make it nice and zesty.
All these dishes use great ingredients, prepared simply and presented without fuss, just like this pressed ham tureen.
When you think about something like a pub, you know, it's rustic. So keep the food rustic, yeah? So in terms of presentation, dots and fucking bits and bobs, get it on there. That's it, end of story.
All the chefs have impressed me this week, but I think Karen's got the maturity to run the kitchen.
So you're gonna take the reins?
Yeah.
You are, yeah? And what happens if
he
starts to change things again? What are you going to do?
Put my foot down. Oi. No way.
You put your foot down?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Be tough.
It's time to show Brian and Elaine their new menu. I've replaced their complicated, fussy food with 25 classic pub dishes.
Surprise, surprise. Simple, straightforward, honest British pub food. Yeah? And nothing too quirky.
I'm well impressed.
Roast, rib of beef, stunning Yorkshire puddings. Jug of gravy, fish and chips, beautiful sausage and mash, Lancashire hot pot, and apple and blackberry crumble.
I'm proud of what I can see.
The secret behind this menu here and being completely traditional in terms of pub food is just the speed it can fly out at. Yeah?
With two sittings in the dining room, the chefs will be under pressure. But it's Brian and Elaine I'm worried about. If they can't relax and speed up the service, we'll be screwed.
Do we say our prayers now?
I'm shaking like a leaf inside. I don't know whether I'm this planet, next planet, but I'm definitely on a traditional pub planet.
He better be. The pub is packed out tonight, but if Brian and Elaine are going to start paying off their huge debts, this can't be a one-off.
16 minutes from the start of the main course, Kat. Two roast beef.
It's keep fantastic. It
nice. First table,
keep it nice,
yeah? Rapido.
Okay.
Here we go. Ooh. And last out those cobwebs.
For the first time ever, they're aiming to fill the dining room twice over, so they can't waste time pouring wine or gravy for the customers tonight.
Mr. Foster, yes, you've got him on table four, Lane.
Oh, he needs to be on three, sorry.
Right. Did you wait long?
No.
No? 5 minutes. Perfect. Gravy happy with?
Gravy and Yorkshire pudding, sensational.
Fantastic.
So far, so good. The kitchen seems to be coping well under pressure.
Now, just be careful. All these main courses flying out now. Dessert's next. Right, how many have we done?
I guess about 40, maybe.
Yeah, I think about 45, just come up to 50. Yeah? Over halfway, yeah? Keep it going, yes?
But out front, there's a disaster waiting to happen. It's 8:30 and they're slipping into old habits. The bar is full of people waiting to be seated. Brian and Elaine haven't got the first customers off the tables yet.
Brian, we've got a bit of a queue forming, yeah? Can we sit some guests down?
Yes, we're just trying to get them to move the tables to sit them down.
If they don't move, tell
me. Right, where's the Rioja? I'll get somebody to bring the bill for you. Thanks.
We've got to get them out of these tables now. You know, that's where we've got to be firm now, yes?
Yep.
What are you finding hard at the transition? It's not a restaurant, it's a pub.
Yep.
So don't be scared after one hour, 55 minutes. Would you mind taking coffee in the bar or come and have a drink in the bar? Change those tables.
Yep.
If you don't do that in the next 15 minutes, we're going to be in the fucking shit.
Have you got a bill for table... that one, whichever one it is?
It's been touch and go. But at last, the second sitting are at their tables.
That's the hardest thing right now, isn't it? Yeah. Got to turn it around. And for the first time ever, it's starting to run like a pub.
The Fenwick Arms is buzzing. The Real Gravy is being lapped up, and traditional pub food has hit the spot.
I had roast beef, and it was so good. It's with Real Gravy on it. Nice. Lovely.
If Brian and Lane can keep up the pace, they might just pull this off.
I mean, hell, it's a lot of excitement. The adrenaline is absolutely pounding through me. Keeping all quiet.
It's been a huge success. And finally, the penny's dropped for Brian. He's realised that the kitchen runs better without him.
I think the team have just been bloody believable. They've done it. I've not been there. I've not had to come in and where's this, where's that, where the other. And I am just so proud of them all. Wow, what a night.
At times this week, I've seriously doubted it was possible. But tonight, the Fenwick Arms has been transformed from a stuffy dining room into a vibrant, packed pub.
How much money do we take?
The till...
Yep.
..tells me we've done 2,447...
Yes! Get in there! Yeah.
Fantastic.
£2,000 more than last Sunday lunch.
Yep.
Brian, what does that tell you?
Changing the menu and doing it simpler has worked.
Yeah, well, since I've been here, that was the first night I witnessed all of you running a pub. And I'm not going to come back to what I came and saw a week ago, yes?
No, you're not.
No. No Chef Whites, no knife rack.
Nope.
Nowhere near it.
Nope.
No. There was one little problem. I found a Barbie plate. Please, Eddie. Wrap it up in cling film, dig a hole, and hide it, yes?
Yeah.
Promise me?
Yep.
Good man, go. Eddie! Oh, no! Eddie!
A month ago, I left Brian and Elaine running a busy pub. I'm dying to find out if they've kept it up. I'm on my way back to surprise them for Sunday lunch.
The car park's looking full. Always a good sign. And the last Sunday I was here, they struggled to serve 22 people.
Good. Campaign for Real Gravy still there. The menu, we can notice it this time.
Good evening, good afternoon. Hello, how are you?
Fine, thank you. And yourself?
Yeah, very indeed, thank you. Where's Brian?
In the kitchen.
He's where?
In the kitchen.
He's in the kitchen?
With the lights.
What in the fuck is going on? The fuck are you doing in here? Hello?
Hello. I thought you were doing the Great Northern Run.
What are you doing dressed in those?
Working.
Why?
Because I haven't got anybody else.
Oh, for God's sake.
There's only Sharon. And Chris's day off today. So I'm on my own.
It turns out just 1 week after I left, Brian was back in the kitchen and Nathan left to go back to college.
Oh, fuck me. Brian!
Yes, Gordon.
I cannot believe I've just found you back in the kitchen.
Couldn't get any staff. And we're just trying to recruit to replace the one who went.
Bloody hell. What else is back? Truthfully, before I start rummaging around and looking for it.
Some of the plates.
Oh, no.
Yep, some of the plates. That was...
Oh, no. Why?
Because what you taught us was listen to your customer.
Oh, here we go.
So we did.
So your customers are saying, bring back square plates?
No, what they wanted was the wow factor on the food again. That's what they wanted.
What do you mean the wow factor on the food? It's a pub, Brian!
Yes, but...
If you're starting to become a restaurant slowly, within a month, you're destined for trouble.
We went a little way down the road, but kept the menu basically along the lines of what you were saying.
Prawn cocktail still on there?
Yes.
Yeah, we've changed that.
You've changed that?
Yeah,
it's
we've
not
done
in
the
wine
prawn.
Glass.
It's not in the wine glass.
No.
We've done it the way that we've always done it.
Go on.
And it sells exceptionally well.
Oh, here we go. How did you used to serve the prawn cocktail before I put it in a glass? Remind me.
Scallop shell.
Oh,
with
for fuck's
it on
sake.
Scallop shell. But it sells and the customers
Brian.
Like it.
Brian.
Yep.
Prawns don't live inside scallop shells.
Nope. But they don't live inside glasses either.
Oh, oh, fuck me. Fucking hell.
The good news is that thanks to the Real Gravy campaign, just 1 month Sunday lunch take-ins have doubled and the overall turnover is up by 30%.
I'll start with a prawn cocktail and a scalloped shell, please. Yeah, it hasn't got mashed potato pie around the outside, has it?
Yes.
Oh, fucking hell.
So this is Brian's wow factor. He really is a stubborn old bat.
Fuck it. I'll do it myself. Nice. That's what I expect to see, a prawn cocktail. No problem.
Brian is making an incredible 250 litres of gravy a week, and I'm not surprised people are flocking for this roast.
My God, the size of the portions, extraordinary. Nice gravy. And nothing farted around with, do you know what I mean? Lovely. I don't think there's a beef, a Yorkshire pudding, anywhere in the country today that could have matched what you served me for lunch.
Thank you.
So, you know, don't piss around with it. You don't need to. And whilst I'm slightly concerned that you're back in the kitchen, I hope it's for a temporary time only.
It is.
Because if I talk to this lady in 6 months' time, God forbid, and you've popped your fucking clogs in there on that stove, I'll be fucking furious. Get out of there. Run your pub, not your kitchen. Please.
I will. And I'm absolutely confident that the way you have set us up, the way the menu is set up, is going to work.
Look at me and tell me.
Yes.
Will you let go?
Yes.
Because if you do let go, there's every chance that this is going to work. You know that?
Brian is full of surprises. He's got a new reason to log on to his computer. He's running the campaign for Real Gravy website.
September, 34,500
hits. In 1 month?
In 1 month.
34,500?
Yeah.
It's fucking fantastic.
Yeah.
34,500 people logging on to find out more about the Fenwick Arms. Do me a favour now. Start thinking about your next campaign. She's crazy, like. And I know what it should be. Campaign for a real prawn cocktail.
Now you're taking the piss.
I'm not taking the piss. You were taking the piss, serving in a fucking scallop shell.
Good luck.
Thanks very much.
Good night.
Thank you.
Bye. Take care.
Bye.
Fucking hell. Scallop shells in a prawn cocktail. Fucking hell. Fucking hell.
30 years.
Vote online for the gastro gripes that get right up your nose at channel4.com/Ramsay.